I'm sure you have already seen all the fantastic multitasking features Apple introduced in the new iPadOS 26. It really seems like this is the year Apple finally decided to make the iPad more like a MacBook. So I wanted to investigate if I could totally ditch my MacBook with an iPad. After 2 weeks of intense use, I feel like there are definitely many noticeable enhancements, but to totally replace a Mac, I kind of feel like it's still not there yet. I'm going to talk about my experience in detail in this video. First, the things I do like. This definitely includes the enhanced multitasking. We are getting a new windowing system. In the past, we had Stage Manager, and it is still here in this version. I feel like my problem with Stage Manager is that the concept of stage, to me, it's a little bit intimidating. As an average user, I don't really need to pair my apps into different stages. I just open them and use them whenever I need. Now, with the new windowing system, the apps you open are no longer tied to a specific stage. You can freely open any apps you want, resize them, move them around, just like the multitasking we usually do on a Mac, compared with the old split-screen mode, which can be a little bit hard to use when you need to switch between different apps. This new windowing system just makes everything easier and more smooth. We are also getting all those macOS-like window controls, like the three buttons on the top left. They also enable window arrangement, which is really helpful with multitasking. The second thing I really like is the enhanced Files app on iPad. iPad's file management has really been an issue in the past, but now the Files app on iPad looks more like macOS. You can easily adjust the columns, see more details about your files, customize folders, and so on. We are also getting this new context menu when you do the right click. It allows you to do more quick but powerful actions directly from there, like opening your files with the apps you prefer. My favorite function in Finder on macOS is that I can quickly convert an image or resize it directly from Finder. And now I can do it on iPadOS as well. I don't need to install a third-party app anymore. We are also getting more macOS-like elements throughout the whole system. For example, the new menu bar on top of the screen allows you to do many quick actions and also shows you what you can do inside a certain app. You can also add folders to the dock, just like on a Mac. And you can open Expose by doing a three-finger swipe on your trackpad. We are also getting this new preview app that allows you to do more with your documents, like PDFs. Those are all the new flashy signature enhancements in iPadOS 26. However, after a deep dive for 2 weeks, I realized there is a reason the iPad will forever be an iPad. There will always be some sort of difference between macOS and iPadOS in the foreseeable future. The first problem I have is that I kind of feel like at this point, iPad is still a touch-first device. In iPadOS 26, even though you are using a Magic Keyboard with it, you are still not going to get the same experience with a MacBook. Certain things haven't been optimized for keyboard, mouse, or trackpad control. For example, the new window controls, those three buttons, they are normally small and hidden in the corner. When you hover your mouse cursor over them, they become larger. The issue for me is that they are kind of small and it's hard to focus on them and point my cursor to click them. And sometimes those three buttons are not gonna become larger when you hover them because of some UI interfering issue. After a while of trying, I just feel like I don't really want to use it anymore. I just use the keyboard shortcuts instead. Command M to minimize, Command W to close the window, and Globe F to make it full screen. The window snapping feature on a Mac, you can just drag your window to the edge of the screen. But on iPad, if you are using a trackpad, you have to mimic the way you use your finger. You need to throw the window to the edge of the screen, which is really hard to do with the trackpad. I think my success rate is under 5%. In this case, keyboard shortcuts have also become my best friends. I just use globe control and left, right, up, down to snap the window to the side I want. Then, not specific to window management, but three-finger dragging is still not available in iPadOS 26. On the Mac, I use three-finger dragging a lot to move windows and drag files. But on iPad, whenever I need to move something with my trackpad, I still need to press down and use one finger to move around. I can turn on the tap to drag in accessibility settings, but it still feels different with the three-finger drags compared with a Mac. That's another thing I need to use my machine in different ways on two different platforms. The second thing causing me problem is that I feel like the overall logic of control or how things work in iPadOS 26 are still different from macOS. If you are a power user of a Mac, you are super familiar with macOS and you use it every day, you might notice that even with all those new enhanced multitasking features, your efficiency might still not be as high as when you are using macOS. For example, I want to talk about the dock. To me, on macOS, the dock is kind of like my secret weapon for multitasking. It acts like a central hub of my computer. I have all my most used apps added to my dock. Whenever I need to open something, I just quickly click the icon and I'm good to go. Whenever I minimize a window, it goes directly to the right side and I can easily open them up when I need them again. The indicators at the bottom of the icons are also very helpful. They just keep reminding me which app I was just using, and I can quickly jump back to where I was. But for iPad, because it's originally designed for full screen use, the dock is always hiding. You can only have it constantly showing up when you are in window mode and you have your window small, which I don't think people will use it in this condition for that long. So when the dock is hiding, I lose my multitasking weapon. Whenever I need to open another app, I need to go to the home screen or go to Spotlight or just manually make my dock show up, which I feel slows down my workflow when I need to quickly open another app. Also, in iPadOS, there is no indicator showing you which apps you have in the background. I know we have the recent apps section in the right side of the dock, or we can do Command Tab to switch between recent apps, or maybe just do three-finger swipes. But you know they don't really mean the same thing. On iPadOS, the whole background app concept is just different compared to macOS. When you are using an iPad, Apple just doesn't want you to think too much about background apps, just like when you are using an iPhone. But to me, for multitasking, it's kind of helpful to get a clear sense of which apps you have in the background. In that case, you can easily go back to the thing you were using before and not be distracted by things you might have opened a while ago but don't really need it at that point. Whenever I go to my recent apps, I always get distracted by all those other random apps I was using before, like social media, video streaming apps, something like that. And I feel like it's not really helpful when I want to focus on my work. The next thing that makes me always miss my Mac is iPhone mirroring on macOS. I know maybe I'm asking for too much, but this is definitely my favorite feature on macOS in recent years. When I'm working on my Mac, I can see all my iPhone's notifications and do some quick controls with my phone without picking up my phone. But when I use my iPad, I still need to pick up my iPhone a lot. I know the iPad is running an iOS-like operating system already, so iPhone mirroring might not work on iPad for quite a bit. But honestly, I do wish that at one point I can see my iPhone's notification right on my iPad. But you know what? At this point, I actually feel like they are not the biggest issue. After 2 weeks, I started questioning myself. Even with all the new window management and multitasking features, with iPad's smaller screen size, are we really gonna get the same level of work efficiency as a MacBook? Maybe we will never get the same experience just because of the small screen size. I know at this point, I kind of sounds like that kind of users. When iPad doesn't have multitasking features, I was like, where are the multitasking features? And now I was like, nah, it's not working. I don't like it. But for real, if you force yourself to do all the productivity work on the small iPad, even with iPadOS 26, you might have a similar feeling with me. In these 2 weeks, I was really having fun moving my windows around and try to have multiple windows all together. But in the end, I realized that as long as you are not using the largest 13-inch iPad Pro or iPad Air, if you are like me using an 11-inch or the regular iPad or even the mini, you are going to notice that having multiple windows open at the same time, switching between them all the time, and doing intense work is not that enjoyable. For example, if you have Safari open on the left side, multiple other apps on the other side, everything just becomes pretty small. You need to zoom in and zoom out a lot, and sometimes you need to stick with the mobile version, which is not ideal. To me, this situation, I mean, I can definitely make it work, but the experience is not that great because the screen is just too small. I'm definitely happy to use it for a quick work session when I don't have access to my Mac, but if I have a proper MacBook, I can definitely get things done faster over there. So I don't need to force myself to use the smaller size iPad and dealing with all the multitasking features. And then I feel like this new windowing system is still kind of like a workaround. I still feel like it's not the ultimate solution to fix the multitasking issue on iPads. So how the windowing system works is that it always remembers the last stage you use an app in. For example, if I use Safari in window mode last time, the next time I open Safari, it will show up in window mode. If I use it in full screen last time, the next time I open it, it will show up in full screen. The problem I've noticed is that it becomes really hard to predict or expect how an app will show up when you launch it. A lot of time, I want to have an app open in full screen mode, but because I use it in window mode last time, it still opens in window mode, and I have to manually change it into full screen mode. That just creates an extra step. After once, after twice, I'm fine with them. But if I need to do that too many times, in the end, I just feel like I don't want to use the window mode anymore. I just want to make everything full screen because that will give me the most immersive experience on my small iPad. The way to help with this issue is to add the window mode switcher into your control center. But in the end, it still feels like a workaround, and the whole experience is just not as fluent as using a Mac. On the Mac, everything can open in window, and I have no problem with that because I always have a large screen or a display, but that could be an issue on iPad. And those workarounds and extra steps will in the end slow down our workflow. Okay, so that's all the details I want to talk about regarding my 2-week iPadOS 26 experience. Overall, I feel like the new features are definitely gonna enhance our multitasking experience. However, if you are a longtime Mac user and you are super familiar with everything in macOS, I just don't think an iPad running iPadOS 26 can fully replace your Mac yet. This is because many things still work differently between macOS and iPadOS, no matter the logic of control or the concept of the devices themselves. Okay, that's all for today's video. I want to know, have you tried iPadOS 26 yet? If you have, what's your experience? Let us know in the comments. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know as well. If you find this video useful, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more tech-related content, be sure to subscribe. Now check out some other videos of mine. I'm sure you will be interested as well. Have a nice day!